tell you a story. This is the story of Peter and the Wolf. It's a musical story where the characters are represented by different instruments of the orchestra. For example, the bird is represented by the flute. The duck by the oboe. The cat by the clarinet. The grandfather by the bassoon. The horns. And the hero of our story, Peter, is represented by all of the strings. The hunters by the woodwinds. Hunter's rifles by the timpani. Early one morning, Peter opened the gate and went out into the big green meadow. On a branch of a big tree sat a little bird, Peter's friend. "All is quiet, all is quiet," chirped the bird gaily. Just then, a duck came waddling round. She was glad that Peter had not closed the gate. and decided to take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow. And she jumped into the water. Seeing the duck, the little bird flew down upon the grass, settled next to her, and shrugged his shoulders.
"What kind of bird are you if you can't fly?"
said the bird. To this, the duck replied,
"And what kind of bird are you if you can't swim?"
And dived into the pond. They argued and argued, the duck swimming in the pond, the little bird hopping along the shore. Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. He noticed a cat crawling through the grass. The cat thought, the bird is busy arguing. I'll just grab him. Stealthily she crept towards him on her velvet paws. "Look out!" shouted Peter. The bird immediately flew up into the tree. While the duck quacked angrily at the cat. From the safety of the middle of the pond, the cat walked around the tree and thought, "Meow, is it worth climbing up so high? By the time I get there, the bird will have flown away." Grandfather came out. He was angry because Peter had gone into the meadow.
"It'd be a dangerous place. If a wolf should come out of the forest, what would you do then, eh?"
Peter paid no attention to his grandfather's words, Boys like him are simply not afraid of wolves. Grandfather took Peter by the hand, locked the gate, and led him home. Peter gone, and a big grey wolf came out of the forest. In a twinkling, the cat climbed up the tree. The duck quacked, and in her excitement, foolishly jumped out of the pond. No matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. He was getting nearer and nearer and nearer, catching up with her. And then he got her, and with one gulp, swallowed her. And now, this is how things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch. The bird on another. Not too close to the cat. And the wolf walked round and round the tree, looking at them with greedy eyes. Peter, in the meantime, stood behind the closed gate watching all that was going on. He wasn't at all afraid. He ran home, got a strong rope and climbed up the high stone wall. Now one of the branches of the tree, around which the wolf was walking, stretched out over the wall. Grabbing hold of the branch, Peter lightly climbed over onto the tree. Peter said to the bird, "Fly down and circle round the wolf's head. Only take care that he doesn't catch you." The bird almost touched the wolf's head with his wings, while the wolf snapped at him again and again and again. He was very angry. The bird did worry the wolf, and oh, how the wolf wanted to catch him. But the bird was cleverer, and the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso with his rope, and carefully letting it down, and pulled with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose. Peter tied the other end of the rope to the tree. And the wolf's jumping only made the rope round his tail tighter. Just then, out of the woods came the hunters. Following the wolf's trail and shooting as they went. Thank you. wolf. Now you should help us take him to the zoo. And now, imagine the triumphant procession. Peter at the head. After him, the hunters leading the wolf. Winding up the procession, Grandfather and the cat. Grandfather tossed his head discontentedly. Well, if Peter hadn't caught Wolf, what would have happened then, eh?
Young people nowadays, they've got no respect. They think they can do what they want.
Above them flew Birdie, chirping merrily.
My, what brave fellows we are, Peter and I. Look what we've caught.
And if you listen very carefully, to hear the duck quacking inside the wolf, because the wolf, in his hurry and with a fortunate lack of decorum, had swallowed her alive. Thank you.
Thank you.